on my anniversary. Amen.
Amen.
And the church's anniversary, one of the young ladies we met through somebody else, but God still got us together. Yes. And the other people are not together. But you know, that's how God works. Amen.
Amen. Amen.
If of course somebody else gets upset with somebody, doesn't mean you have to get upset with them.
Come on now.
Me and this young lady, we have a fellowship that people keep talking to her while she's still dealing with me.
Yep.
I said, well, I don't think I ever did it. And she said, no, you ain't did it. They just jealous. I said, well, you know what? Be jealous. Guess what? I'm going to still keep on doing God's work. Amen. But she's a young lady that God has put us together. With her putting us together, I find out that we're all over the world because she's got us on Facebook, YouTube, and everything else you can think of that the media knows that we're, TFT is alive.
Amen.
But I realize that. When one of my girlfriends that I haven't seen in over 10 years happened to call me up on the phone, I said, well, where did you get my number? She said, well, somebody told me you were on one of them stations in Alabama. And I called to find out the number and got your number. But I wanted to let you know I saw you. And I said, go ahead, girl. Now you're an apostle? I said, yeah. She said, all right. But I thank God for her.
Amen.
Because I mean, we are not just a little church that's not doing nothing, but we're a church that's doing something.
Hallelujah.
Amen. And I wanted her to come and give her word on our last day for our anniversary.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
One more time. Stand on your feet. She went on a retreat and she's just as crazy as us.
Hallelujah.
Do not want to know the holy of the thou. One day she put everything one day she put down everything we did since the first day she met us. I said, Lord, I didn't know I did all that much. But I want you to put your hands together for none other than Apostle.
Yes! Yes.
Amen. Yes. Amen. It's Sam Allen. Amen.
All you got to do is go on pause and say, Lord, I need you. Because when you open up your mouth, you're locked into the presence. That's why he said, speak the word and be set free. Many of you all are just murmuring. And God is tired of that whining and complaining. He said, I've given you the authority. Act like you know. When you was in the world, you stepped up to some unknown men and said, hey, what's up? But now, because you're in Christ, you sit up there and, listen, baby, you got to go through. And that's what it's all about.
Amen.
16 years of going through.
Yes, Lord.
They came, they went, they left the havoc in the land. Right. God sent the fire to burn up the mess.
All right.
And then he did a new thing.
Come on.
It wasn't easy.
Go ahead.
You had to deal with a whole lot of depression. The strong men of heaviness. And that's what we're going to talk about today.
All right.
Go ahead now.
I gave some of y'all questionnaires.
Yes,
and those that didn't get any, please make sure you get a copy. And do the test. And do the score. Many of y'all, without even realizing, is dealing with depression.
Go ahead.
And have no clue.
Well.
So, let me start my scripture. And I want to thank the apostle for us always being together. Because like she said, I met her through somebody else. That's how God did the divine hookups. Me and her been together years. Right. While the other people are no longer a part of my life whatsoever.
Right.
Only because they were counterfeits. Let's call it what it was.
Right.
Many counterfeits running out there.
Right.
Or as they say, wolf and sheep clothing. But unless you understand your assignment and the call on your life,
go ahead.
You won't hear what God says.
Thank you.
Even when Elder Stinson met him at somebody's ordination, got a chance to go to his church, recorded a powerful message, and caught him. King up one on Staten Island. He taught him because he kept it real. He threw his stuff out there. And that's how you preach.
Amen.
And I saw a little snippet from Saturday. You set up the church. I was laughing. First of all, give me honor to God who is ahead of my life. The angel of this house, my buddy. All those in leadership, from bishops, pastors, evangelists, the missionary, and even on down to little Avery. May the Lord bless you. Grant you showers of blessings and total healings in all areas of your life. As you do what God has called you to, not me.
Amen.
Time for people pleasing is over with.
Hallelujah.
It's time to be God pleasers.
Oh, yes.
Amen.
Amen.
Well, my scripture reading comes from two places. And I bless you, Lord, because I'm telling you, I had a rough night with a demon, but we made it through. My first scripture reading comes out of Isaiah 61 and 3.
Right.
It says, to grant consolidation and joy to those who mourn in Zion. To give them an ornament, a garland or a diadem, which is a crown of beauty instead of ashes. The oil of joy instead of mourning, or whatever Father has for people drinking oil today, hallelujah. All right. The garment expressive of praise instead of heavy burden and failing spirits, that they may be called oaks of righteousness. Y'all see the oak tree, how strong is it? All right. Lofty, strong, and magnified, distinguished for uprightness, justice, and right standing with God, the planting of the Lord, that he may be glorified. A lot of people ain't trying to glorify God, they're trying to glorify man. And that's why a lot of things is not happening.
Yeah.
In Psalm 111, 2 through 3, which is your theme, the works of the Lord are great, sought out by all those who have delight in him. He works, his work is honorable and glorious, and righteousness endures forever. A lot of people got phony, glorious workings. We've seen a lot of the going around. That's why we have so much depression in the land. People are not in position.
Come on.
They don't want to get in position because, first of all, they're disobedient. They're rebellious. And they operate in witchcraft.
Yeah, hallelujah.
The title of my message is Turn It Around. Whenever we awake and turn via the television, the telephone or the telephone, the cell phone, text messages, email, snail mail, Facebook, Twitter, and so many other internet addresses of information highway, without a doubt, hell and has broken out all around us.
Go ahead.
Since Adam and Eve were kicked out of the garden due to their disobedience, chaos and sin has been running rampant.
Okay.
Wow. Mark 13 and 7 says, and when you hear wars and rumors of wars, do not get alarmed, troubled, and frightened. It is necessary that these things take place, but the end is not yet.
Well,
that's right.
There are presently 64 countries involved in wars around the world and 571 militias, guerrillas, and separatist groups.
Go ahead.
World epidemics is bird flu, E. coli, contamination food, and currently Ebola outbreak.
Go ahead now.
All right.
Yes. Even in the news today, it says today's police put on a gun and a camera. Why? Because all these cameras be doing a real 411.
Uh-huh.
And they gotta make sure that their stuff is correct so that they don't get caught up in some mess.
Uh-huh.
All these killings going on unnecessarily.
Well.
We have ISIS planning to attack New York City even like that.
Right.
You know, ISIS is over there in the Middle East, and
they're
beheading Christian children. We even had a dangerous Massachusetts teen, no less, on the run after the police said he drugged, beat, and raped a 16-year-old girl. Then snapped a video of the bruised woman. We even have a mommy who uses her 7-year-old daughter to handle money as she sells cocaine.
Yes.
In a Texas nightclub.
Yes.
These are just a few facts of reality going on in our world, which allows us without a doubt to understand the world is operating the strongman of heaviness. There are many other strongmans like the spirit of divination, familiar spirits, spirit of jealousy, lying spirits, we need to kill that in the church real quick. Perverse spirit, spirit of haughtiness, which is nothing but pride of self and no power. Spirit of heaviness, spirit of whoredom. Some of y'all still creeping on the down low. Spirit of infirmity, dumb and dark spirit, spirit of bondage, spirit of fear, seducing spirits that want to sit up there and tell you, you know, check this out. I got this real deal. And if you just do this, check this out. The real deal is the blood of Christ.
All right.
We have the spirit of Antichrist, spirit of error, and the spirit of death. But today we're talking about the strong men of heaviness. Starting with that questionnaire I gave you, just took a look at it. We're going to expose the righteous attack that has many unaware and paralyzed from doing the work of the kingdom. Many of us are living in hostile environments called home. This is the place you turn your key to lock out the world and its destruction of assault, whether verbal, physical, or psychological. Yet, you are someone else's punching bag through hurtful words, power, and control. Many of us have found ourselves in this late dating time caregivers of our grandchildren or children. You love them dearly, but you're not economically or you have lack of good health and you cannot effectively raise this next generation. So what are you going to do? Many times when it is time to pay the monthly bills, you're reminded of that saying, taken from Peter to pay Paul.
All right.
And both Peter and Paul are hollering, there's nothing to take, go away, go away. So what do you do? Psalm 121 and one said, I will lift my eyes to the hills,
all right.
Which cometh my help.
Yes.
When we look up towards, when we look at the words turn and around, we know one, action is the main, a completion. Two, turn is to cause, to move around, rotate, to reserve, reverse the position and place.
Well,
some of y'all need to get up and reverse some positions and places. Woo! This is only for those that know what I'm talking about. This is not a personal attack. This is God said, keeping it real, because you see, he know it all.
Uh-huh.
So that delusional spirit is operating up in the church that God don't see. And check it out, pick a book, a lot of us seeing a lot of things too. Psalm 119 and 133 and 8 says, establish my steps and direct them by means of your word.
All
right. Let not any iniquity have dominion over me.
All right.
So God is saying a lot of this y'all doing, all you got to do is open up your mouth.
All right.
Because let me tell you something, I'm not perfect, and I know it. I went through that craziness. That's what sent me to that crack cocaine and other stuff, because I had to be perfect.
All right.
I got issues.
All right.
But God is working on me.
Amen.
Right. I talked to him about it.
Come on,
I looked at some pictures I had when I was size 5, and now I'm a plus size. And I said, Lord, I know you're working on it too. It's not that I eat wrong, because God has changed my appetite. I don't exercise. That's the reality. If I go up in the palace that God has given me, there's no need for me to have everything's in here.
Right.
But I'm going to have to do something, because you know what? I don't like being a big girl. I know I'm a luxury, but so far, my health is good, so we ain't going to rest.
All
right. Amen.
All right.
Go ahead.
All right. So let's talk about what some of the causes of depression in natural. Sadness. Feeling hopeless and empty. Crying for no obvious reason. Guilt. Feeling worthless and helpless. Because you have no self-esteem and no self-worth. Irritable. Feel angry, anxious, and restless. And men, feeling depressed, often express their aggression through recklessness behavior. You have trouble concentrating, making decisions, or remembering details. You have aches and pains, headaches, stomach aches. You do not respond to treatment, because that's not the problem. You're feeling tired all the time. Slow down. Loss of interest and pleasurable activities for those that are married, sex, hobbies, and social interactions. Neglect hygiene and responsibility. Sleep changes, waking you up too early in the morning, not able to fall asleep or sleeping too much. Appetite changes, eating too much or too little. Weight gain or weight loss. And then the one that really comes to sign round is a suicide loss. Loss of lifestyle, loss of employment, loss of home. Now you're homeless, poor health, loss of loved one, disobedience, rebellion, and witchcraft. Let's talk about some folks in the Bible who went through depression and bring it up to the day. The first one we know that was hit with depression was Adam and Eve.
Yep.
And he said, who told you that you were naked?
All right.
Have you eaten of the tree which I commanded you that you should not eat? So God drove out the man, and he placed at the east of the Garden of Eden a cherubim and a flame of sword, which turned every way, creeping in, then you'll come back undercover.
All right.
To keep and guard the way to the tree of life.
Uh-huh.
That was the first one. I'd have depression too after all that. Got played like a fiddle by a snake. Didn't have to warm for nothing. Women had to all of a sudden go through labor pain. Didn't have to do that before. I went $19 for the only one I have, and he's 22 next month. The next one was Cain. But for Cain and his offering, he had no respect for God.
Nope.
So Cain was exceedingly angry and indignant. And he looked sad and depressed. Behold, you have driven me out this day from the face of the land, and from your face I will be hidden. And I'll be a fugitive and a vagabond and a wanderer on earth. Whoever finds me will kill me. The Lord said, no, we're going to walk on you. Say, no, you're mine, but you're just out. That's it.
The boot.
You know what I mean? God gets tired.
Yes.
He gets tired. We need leadership get tired.
Yes.
Woo.
And that's why many times, as I get tired of some of my folks, I said, Lord, you got to strengthen me, because you know I'm ready to do a Bruce and roundhouse kick. I'm tired. They're rebellious. They don't want to listen. And all of a sudden, they want to put on their powerful cap, and they ain't ready to have.
All right.
They act like we do this because we want. Let me tell you something. Anybody call himself a leadership, and you're going for pastor on up, trust me, we didn't want to be this. I enjoy being an evangelist, hanging out, chilling, nothing to worry about. But God said no. I made a promise to God when I was a prisoner. I said, God, you clean me up from this crack. That was in 2000. I'm going anywhere and do anything for you.
That's right.
I made myself available. And I meant what I said. Because I was grateful.
Yes,
not knowing, shoot, Daddy had a setup for me. Look at me today. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
But he had to clean me up too.
Yeah.
I had a lot of pain. A lot of issues I had not resolved because I didn't know how.
Uh-huh.
I was raised as a witch, fifth generation white witch. Uh-huh. But because I came in Christ, I learned how to forgive and understand how the enemy came to attack the family.
Right.
That's his job. My job now is to show that even when I walk in some churches and I see the witches, I'm like, I ain't impressed with you either.
All right.
Amen. Many of you today are operating in rebellion and witchcraft. Let me back it up for that's what I'm talking about. You remember the story of Ananias and Sapphira? Sapphira?
Yep.
They had their stuff, said they were going to sell it, and then they decided to dip in the pocket.
Uh-huh.
First of all, they robbed themselves, but they could have simply said, no, Lord, I don't want to do that.
Yes.
Oh, Lord, I'll give you 50, and I'll keep 50. God wants people to be real.
That's it.
If I want to sell all my property,
you
should have said bargain, because it's what God expects for us. He didn't give you a mouth to sit there and be a robot.
Go ahead.
He gave you a mouth to talk to
him. That's fine.
Because sometimes God sent me some places, and I'm like, Lord, I really got to deal with that? Yeah, I got you. Don't worry. I said, well, thank you. He said, oh, I got you. When you step in, it's going to be right. I said, don't worry about it. And I go on through. And sure enough, God tear it up. And I go on back, and I can go hide. Man, you can bargain with God. Because he knows your heart. So if you got that good old spirit, he ain't dealing with that.
No,
go ahead. And see, it cost those two
people
their lives.
Both of them.
Baby, listen.
Both of them.
My mother said, I'm the biggest child she got. Hallelujah. I can open up my mouth if I need something. The word of God says, you have not, put your ass now. And I beg like that all the time. I get blessed sometimes and sometimes I don't. But the thing is, I ain't got to lie. And if I need some, I'm going to speak. Because people know who I am.
Amen.
You know, if you're blessed, people are going to get a blessing unbelievable too.
Right.
And if you hold on to money you think is yours, trust me, God will take it from you.
Because
I had somebody tell me, well, that's their money. And yada, yada. I said, check this out. You do no outreach. You barely go to church. You're calling on me for prayer. You know my prayers get through. And you don't want to sow seed in this good ground. But I want you to know, this is the year of eviction, as they say, season of casting away. And I'm disconnected.
Amen.
I didn't let nobody rob me in the world, smoking that crack. And I didn't rob nobody. Okay? And I'm not going to let church folks.
It ain't going to happen. You're
preaching
good. His intention was the perfecting
not the counterfeit, but the perfecting and the full equipping of the saints.
Well,
not this broken down mess where God is telling me, I said, to upgrade.
All right.
Woo. Woo. Help me, Jesus. That they should do the work of ministering towards building up Christ's body, the church. Not tear it down with friendly fire. Not tear it down because you hoarding all the money you know wasn't yours. Sit in whether you came or not. Because I'm going to make sure on her website, your PayPal will set up. So whoever can't come, they can just click on PayPal so they can get it to you. Amen. We have all this technology for a reason. And I'm tired of all this buffoonery and foolishness in the church. That it might develop until we all attain oneness in the faith. I'm going to stop here because I really just wanted to make a lot of y'all aware.
Yes.
Come on. 16 years, huh? It was hell. The only thing kept her was the Holy Ghost.
Yeah.
Her relationship with the Holy Ghost. They ain't going to keep you if you don't want to be kept.
All right.
Right.
Many times she could have closed that. I remember that fire happened. How she was running here, running there, running here, running there. Yep. To have services, yep, to harm people, yep, in the midst of all that, could still get the word.
Amen.
Each and every one of y'all have years to do and to complete. Whatever you lack it, you ask the Holy Ghost. You don't have to ask no man nothing. If the Holy Ghost is down on the inside of you,
all right.
It will certainly give you that warning, danger, apostle, danger, and you know to slide out.
Come on.
Amen. And when you're talking to some folks and they act like they're a little retarded or like you don't say something, you know, what, me?
Oh, yeah, you, baby.
Who do you think I'm talking to? It's time to confront a lot of stuff.
All right.
Then the other thing I have a problem with, it's people that are taking all these titles, pastor, bishop, and apostle, and they ain't been seasoned for jack.
All right.
And all you are doing is killing the people of God that are with you, because that same mess on you, not being able to stand in the fiery darts that God allows, like he did Job, gonna wipe people out.
Yeah.
Amen. I remember this one leader, a couple years ago, I gave her word. And I told her she had to do a certain thing at a certain time. And she said she didn't have the money. I said, let me tell you something. For me to save this amount of money, I know it's coming down the pipe. Not only did it come down the pipe, but she called me. And then she said, oh no, I can't do nothing. I have to do this with this other car. She got some more money and didn't do nothing. Today, her church is closed.
Because she was disobedient.
Totally disobedient. And then God even told her, she's a fabulous home. He said, open up the service in your home. Spirit of haughtiness, wouldn't allow it. God even had made a way out of that. And God is saying, enough is enough. Either you're going to stand up and do what I say do, or he's going to shut you down. Many are going to be on the flap of their bed as sickness or kill to her. Because as I said, the world is in depression.
Yes.
And a lot of people don't know how to deal with all that's going on.
Amen.
But we saints of God know how. First of all, we got big mouths. Hallelujah! Hallelujah! Thank you, Lord! Hallelujah! Calm down, Lord. I know you're going to move it on out.
All right.
It's very simple for us. But you got to do it. You got to make the changes.
That's it.
The Spirit leads you.
Amen.
Because if you're really sold out for Christ, it's time to get it right.
Yes. Amen.
Truthfully, I want to say all y'all up in heaven.
Amen.
I'm daily striving too.
Amen.
But I know, even in my own little crazy little mess, God told me you got many, many, many years.
Yes.
In 2 months, I'm celebrating my big 6-0. So you know what?
We thank God.
Thank God. Hallelujah.
All right. Amen. You just got a clearance of what you're going through. Amen.
Amen.